Pakistan ranks 142 in its Human Development Index out of a total of 177 countries. Poverty here has many dimensions: low income, illiteracy, ill health, gender inequality, and environmental degradation. Currently, the population of Pakistan is said to be 115 million, thus increasing the need for greater effort in all social sectors, health being the major one concern. Because of the prevailing situation, the government cannot meet the increased needs of the growing population and allied problems. Support from the private sector is a great help. Pakistan Kidney Institute, which is part of Shifa International Hospital in Islamabad, augments government's efforts in the health sector to some extent in the specialized area of kidney-related ailments. PKI has been on the forefront to meet the challenges of the high prevalence of kidney-related illness, which is surprisingly high. Patients from all walks of life and different socio-economic backgrounds come into the hospital. At no time have they been refused attendance or treatment because of their inability to meet medical or surgical expenses. This institute was formally inaugurated in April 2004. Since the launch of the institute, the urology and nephrology departments have provided state-of-the-art treatment to thousands of patients, irrespective of the financial status, including dialysis services and minor and major surgeries. In fact, the percentage of patients seen through PKI amounts to approximately a quarter of the total patient load in urology. The most recent surgeries were the transplants of Nasir Ali and Amina. These patients received financial support for the treatment. Nasir Ali hails from a low middle class economic background, is 27 years old, married, and brother to 9 sisters. After visiting many doctors and several tests and undiagnosed ailment, a friend recommended a visit to the Shifa International Hospital. The hospital looks expensive, he thought. After the first medical assessment, he was directed to the Pakistan Kidney Institute. Nasir consulted with the PKI team. Mr. Saeed, the transplant coordinator, who briefed Nasir on the donor requirements and eligibility. Dr. Saeed Akhtar, head of the urology department, examined him next, apprising him of the surgery that was required. When Nasir expressed his inability to meet treatment expenses, he was directed to see Dr. Sobia Hafiz. They went to meet Dr. Hafiz to discuss the financial situation, who made the assessment that would entitle Nasir for financial support. However, before any surgery could take place, Nasir was required to follow pre-surgery standard procedures. Nasir came with apprehensions that if there were any diagnostic tests needed, he would have to run all over town. But he was assured by the PKI staff that all that was required would be taken care of within the premises of the Shifa International Hospital, which offers state-of-the-art diagnostic facilities. Nasir's sister donated her kidney. She is mother of 7 children. Her husband is a driver. She said, "We are 9 sisters and Nasir is our only brother. We all wanted to help, but I was chosen to be the lucky one." Members of the Board of Governor come from diverse fields and with varied experiences. They meet every 3 months to discuss the progress of PKI and ways to improve the function of the institute, as well as fundraising strategies. Nasir is on his way to recovery and hopeful of leading a healthy life. Amna had just 2 days ago traveled from Saudi Arabia, where her father works as a driver. She is 7 years old and visually impaired. She too had damaged kidneys and needed a kidney transplant. When asked, the father said that he opted for Pakistan because he discovered that excellent facilities were available at Pakistan Kidney Institute in Islamabad, where a team of highly qualified doctors provided state-of-the-art care with excellent patient survival rates. He was further relieved by the fact that there would not be as great a financial burden as yet. This is Dr. Saeed Akhtar, who together with his team of doctors had made a definite mark on the treatment on patients suffering from kidney diseases.
Pakistan Kidney Institute specifically caters to poor and needy people of our society suffering from kidney and other urological ailments. These services are provided under one roof by highly trained physicians from across the world who do not charge any fees for their services. Patients are either treated completely free or at the cost price. These services include kidney transplant, complex cancer surgeries, reconstructive surgeries, stone surgeries, and surgery for leakage of urine. By the grace of God, Pakistan Kidney Institute is a very humble beginning of 4 beds, which is destined to become a state-of-the-art 100-bed facilities in future, where excellence in healthcare and clinical care of the patient, teaching at undergraduate and postgraduate level, and cutting-edge research would be our mission. Please help us achieve this goal so that we can serve our country better.
The philosophy of this hospital is to encourage donors who are relatives to ensure greater tissue match possibilities, and does not endorse purchase of an organ from the market. A cousin donated a kidney for Amna. When asked, she said,
"Maine apni cousin ko jo hai na gurda gift kiya hai.
I did not donate a kidney but gifted it to my little cousin." The demand on medical staff and resources is great because of the prevalence of disease and flood of patients. Yet the hospital staff deals with the situation as deftly as possible, smiling and in a professional manner. Children like Amna deserve to live. Help Pakistan Kidney Institute through your donation so that more children and adults who suffer from debilitating kidney-related ailment lead healthy lives.
Please help the ailing and underprivileged members of our society by donating generously to Pakistan Kidney Institute. Your worthy contributions will be expended with utmost care and will inshallah ensure excellent quality for the deserving patients.